When you create your Intercom account, we have some workflows set up working out of the box. One to set customer expectations, which shows your team's expected reply time when a customer starts a chat in the messenger, and another to send a CSAT survey, which asks a customer to rate their conversation once a chat has ended. These are already live, so in this lesson, we'll walk you through how they work and explore how you can modify them as needed. Let's start with showing your reply time. This is a standard workflow that companies use to set expectations with their customers. Looking at the trigger, we can see that this workflow fires after a customer sends their first message on these channels. Let's take a closer look. This is functioning perfectly as is, but we could customize it in a few different ways. We can change the time mentioned here by hovering and using these settings. Or if you prefer even more control, you can add a bot message that says exactly what you want your reply to be and delete this block. Another thing you could do is edit the path to target a specific audience. This is easy to do by adding branches that create different experiences for one set of customers, like those in a premium or pro plan, and another for the rest. We can easily set the right expectations for multiple audiences within one workflow. Once saved, make sure customers always see this workflow first by placing it to the top of this list. Okay, let's move on to the other workflow we've already configured for you. This one asks for a conversation rating when a teammate closes a conversation. In the trigger here, we can see the audience is configured to users, as we don't want to ask leads, although you could add them easily. This is going to fire in all channels, and most importantly, only when a conversation is closed. That's the best time to ask for a CSAT rating. As for this path here, you can see there's a wait block. So after a conversation is closed, we'll wait 2 minutes just in case the customer wants to ask something else. Then we'll use the CSAT survey. So the cool thing about this is that it's completely customizable. You might want a longer or a shorter wait block, or none at all. And just like most content, you can configure this survey by clicking on it, opening the side drawer, and specifying if a customer can change their rating, and if so, how long they have to do this. Or you can delete our native CSAT survey and use a third-party app you have installed, or just link to something else. With this flexibility, you can capture the sentiment important to you in the way that you want. Now you've seen how easy it is to configure basic workflows, you can start to think about the ones you can create from scratch.